Hello friends, so today I'm going to give you a quick update on the Shogun build. So as you can see, all the parts are painted, like you know, the fork and the swing arm. This stand actually belongs to an RD since we were painting all this, so I thought I will paint that also. There is a bit of work in the mudguard, like you can see there is some bit of spot putty that we can put on these areas and then sand it and then again paint it. So that is about this, and check this out. This is the head, these are the other parts, this is the cylinder, the engine covers. Check out the chain cover, the finish on that. So I have actually applied a lot of clear so that you know these things, like small nips, can be buffed out, because I knew that there will be nips because you know painting outside. So these are the other set. So these are these in-depth items. You know, it's kind of a love or hate thing, because you know, on a black bike, some people might not like this look, but this actually really pops up. So I also got these plated. These would look really nice since all shiny chrome, as you can see. Then this is the top nut, and we also have a couple of amazing bolts. Look at that, the quality is just amazing. See that, these are supposed to come on top of the handle. And these are all the items which are zinc dipped. So you know, we have a divided view about zinc dipping everything, because some people feel that it's a bad idea, but I would say it's a great idea. Reason being, if you go to buy all these spares, it is going to cost you much more. Since all of these are zinc dipped, most of them can be reused, and to tell you very honestly, this is not very expensive. So if you are on a budget to rebuild a bike, especially something like an RX, getting everything zinc dipped is the best idea, because just the nut and bolt kit for restoration costs about 7,000 to 8,000 rupees now. So this is a great idea. For Suzuki, it is very difficult to get these things. As you can see, there are a lot of small stuff, you know. So all these things, like the springs, these are stand springs. So all these things, when zinc dipped, actually costs a lot lesser. So you can see these are the headlight visor bracket, and this is the seat bracket. So it's actually a very nice thing to zinc dip everything, because this would give us a lot of, you know, cheaper and OE quality parts with a new finish on it. So yeah, this is, look at this spring, you know, this just looks as if it came out of the factory. And trust me, this is a 97 model bike, and these things came in the bike in the year 97. So almost everything that you see here is OE. So that's actually an awesome thing to do. So let me put these inside, and we will take this out once we start reassembling the bike. So till that time, I have to keep it in safe custody. So next things which we need to paint is obviously the tank and the side cover. We have to do a little bit of spray underneath, because that is something that I missed out. And once that is done, we will just clear coat it. So yep, some small amount of work is left. And the finish is good, not great, but good. Like, you know, there are small bit of dirt stuck in it, but I've applied so much of clear that, you know, all this can be buffed out. So most likely I'll buff it out. Look at the head, it's just amazing. the quality overall. So yeah, we are good to start reassembly, but at the meantime we will also go ahead and do the bodywork on the tank, side covers, tailpiece, etc. So that is going to be done around this weekend, because that can be delayed. We can start assembling the bike with whatever we have here. So what I'll do is I'll start the assembly process from one side. To be honest, you know, it's a great finish. I never expected it to be this good. The clear that I have used is not only cost effective, it is also amazing in terms of the finish that we get. So I'm going to buy some more of that. We'll do a budget tally at the end of the restoration. So far we have exceeded the budget by around 2000 rupees approximately, but we will actually get a much better, you know, outcome at the end of the restoration. So guys, as you can see, the chassis was painted sometime back and it's looking awesome. So before we install it in the bike, we will just wash the whole thing so that all this watermarks are gone. Then I will show you another set of things. So this bag actually has all the spare parts that we bought. So everything is there, like that packet has all the bearings, everything. This is the wiring kit. Then these are the mud flaps, as you can see. We also got a brand new mud guard, should be up there somewhere. So I'll show you guys that later. So these two side panels, I think this is a mud guard. So this is the brand new mud guard that we got. And then many of you asked me about the tail panel. So this is the tail panel, one single piece fiberglass. This would be a lot more stronger than what comes in these bikes. So it requires a bit of body work. Like you can see, there is a level difference. The tank has been sprayed with 2K primer, so I have to do a bit of body work, which I would do during the next stage of the build. So I'll probably start the assembly from one side. So all these spares are here. Again, check the paint out. It's actually an awesome outcome. So yep, that's the video. Like, share and subscribe. See you in the next one. Bye bye. So yeah, that is the video. So like, share, subscribe and comment on what you liked in this, what you didn't like. You know, these small bit of thrash can just be buffed out. So that's why I applied a lot of clear on this. So yeah, I need a good table to paint. You know, that's the next thing that I'm going to buy. All right, see you again in the next one.